Welcome back to the Big Budget Brainstorm. We are asking three market gurus and the tax guru what markets want to keep themselves happy. Remember last year, the rally that started on the budget yielded gains of what, 25-30% in all of just 3 months. So budgets are capable of unleashing massive rallies by what they do, and more importantly, by what they don't do. So that question to you, Navneet, what will you go long on before the budget?
Not that we trade for 7 days, but in general, I think the things that we like, I think in the next couple of years, with the kind of things that are happening on the rural side, the focus of the government, everybody talked about more money getting into the rural side, affordable housing and all, could do a lot of good. Apart from all the investments that are happening in roads and railways and electricity and the irrigation, crop insurance, more financial and digital connectivity, I think rural India can do very well for next couple of years, and that could be a big theme. Affordable housing could be another big investment theme. So not the people who are into the affordable housing, the construction, but there were a lot of other people who can benefit from it. It seems that globally the economy seems to be recovering. If you look at the economic data, whether in US, in Europe, in Japan, everywhere, and ship movements, variety of things, there seems to be some improvement, and I think India can also have some tailwinds from that side. And apart from that, I think it's a lot more stock-specific bottom-up. For example, from the whole digitalization of finance and financialization of savings, augur very well for the financial sector. But maybe there would be some winners and some losers. Within that, you can pick some good stocks.
So you would be basically cyclically focused?
I think so. The cyclical bias has to increase. Next year, one has to expect that from the level from here on, I think both the consumption is likely to do well, and from the investment side, at least if the government does the heavy lifting, at some point in time, private capex is likely to come.
Financial, I mean, obviously a bias towards that sector for me. Which part of financial? I mean, NBFC is available at basement prices because of the expected hurt from demonetization. Is that what you would bet? Banks, private banks, public banks, MFIs, which one?
I think a mix of all of them, because as I said, the whole digitalization of finance, the lending moving from the informal sector to formal sector, a lot more financialization of savings, a variety of people, the building where we are standing, they are going to get listed. We'll have depository coming in. You had insurance companies now getting listed. You'll have lot many more choices within the financial services.
Okay. Aditya, what would you tell your clients to go long on?
To some extent, I'm going to echo what Navneet said. I think the financial space opens up dramatically. And to some extent, you know, you talked about basement valuations. I don't think that is the case over the recent past. I think a lot of them have bounced back quite substantially. But I do believe that as stocks, as far as stocks, banks, financial stocks are concerned, I think there's a kind of a consumerization of them that is happening, because that's the space they're actually capturing. I think with this entire digital push, the entire Aadhaar push, I think that actually the banks are, or an account holder held by the banks is really a primary form of a consumer business.
Why banks?
So I'd say the banks, I think some of the NBFCs, but you know, as Navneet mentioned, a pool of them. But I do believe that's where you're actually going to get a fair amount of value, a fair amount of volume. And importantly, that's where you're actually going to get valuation support. So I think that's one space. I'd actually also go into the consumer discretionary place. I'd say the auto space would be interesting, because the momentum has not entirely broken on the back of demonetization. I think rates are coming down. I think you will get some tax incentives. And I think a lot of other inflation elements like food and stuff like that is all coming down. So there's just going to be more discretionary money available. So I'd actually play those two, you know, cyclical, but I think there's a structural leg to it.
No IT, no pharma, Prabhat? Are you also playing cyclical?
So we have been playing cyclical for a long time now. I mean, financials has been a favorite space for a very, very long time. That doesn't change. In fact, so, I mean, enough has been said about that, but obviously this whole demonetization thing has really shifted the liquidity away from the informal sector into formal sector. That's what has happened effectively, because currency in circulation is down, bank deposits are up, and not all of that is go back. And therefore, it essentially puts a lot more money in banks to play with in terms of, because the money multiplier in this system is much higher. And as a result, what you see is a fair amount of availability of credit downstream, which also includes NBFCs, bulk funded players, etc. So I think not only does digitization per se increase the financialization of the economy, but also the fact that the pool of liquidity which has been thrust into the banking system essentially makes the credit affordable, the quantum of money available more affordable and available. So I think it in turn can drive the economy up, because you know, the first rally in 2003-04 essentially started when the interest rate hit bottom and the consumer sector started booming because the credit started taking off in two-wheelers and cars, etc. You remember very well. So I think we might be seeing some of that starting to happen, maybe in housing too. Because while housing, prices might be doing whatever, but the volumes have been completely, sort of down in the, because of the fact that affordable housing has been it's not been affordable either because of interest rates or because of rates.
One in part Bombay, of the rate, but I guess
everywhere rates okay. In India is 10%. Well, in 2005 you could borrow a fixed rate loan at 7.5.
Yes.
Today's global interest rates, what are the rate you are getting? 10%. It doesn't make any sense. So I think that is going to change. So
you bet on housing finance companies, housing related.
I think the entire finance space has said. I think that sort of makes sense. In today's
cement?
Cement should start to recover because I think if housing starts to do well at the because the infrastructure related cement demand has happened to it. What has happened is the retail housing because of cash crunch. But if actually affordable housing takes off, then cement growth, which is at 4-5%, actually could move back to 7-8%. It'll take some time, but it'll probably happen.
So that's not on the first one in your list of.
Well, I think finance is something which, if you sort of whatever sector does well, it'll ultimately flow into
finance. Of course, 30% of the Sensex. But you know what, Sudhir? No matter what we speak about sectors and stocks, ultimately, last year the bull was unleashed on Dalal Street primarily because one feared tax measure did not come. Mm-hmm. So, what should the budget not have in terms of
which
taxes?
Which was the fear? Can you remind me?
Of course, capital gains. We started with that. I mean,
right. I would put it this way. I mean, you mentioned the market increase by whatever 25-30% in 3 months post the budget last year. I think last year has been rated as the finance minister's best budget in his current tenure. I would be very surprised if this year's budget is at least not as good as the last year's. So you can draw your conclusion.
What will make it that good? What should be the one quality it should have? Last year the one quality it had which got it a AAA, 3.5% fiscal deficit. Other than the LTCG, that was one measure, the fact that he stuck to the fiscal discipline how.
I would think that that should be the story this year as well about fiscal discipline. But I think more than the equally important, the way the methodology of adhering to that fiscal discipline is what I think, frankly, if I recollect last year, you could not find any sensible critic of his budget last year. That's my memory.
Yes.
And that's what I'm seeing. I can't imagine him dropping below that standard. So we can expect at least as good as last year, if not a transformative budget in the midterm point of the government.
The bull has just started charging, and the way you're putting it, it looks like it can have a good run even before the 1st of February. But yes, our experts can. What, according to you, Navneet, should be the one step? I mean, we also have to cover our tracks for any dangers. What should be the one measure the budget should avoid?
I think everything related to how do you improve the tax to GDP ratio, a lot has been done to shift the parallel economy to the mainstream. Demonetization was one of the last one, and you had several other moves. I think continue moving on that part. And I think one of the biggest thing that has to happen is changing the focus from outlay to the outcome. It's not about how much money in irrigation, but rather how the agriculture productivity, not money in education, but how the literacy rate or whatever, let's say the food, malnutrition.
Definitely.
I mean, there has to be a lot more focus on the outcome rather than only the outlay.
We can't stand in the precincts of India's equity culture and not ask you this question. Prabhat, what might the Sensex yield or the Nifty yield in terms of gains in 2017?
Again, hazard a guess. I think we are about 4-5% away from our 5-year average valuation. So the average valuation of Sensex is close to 16.7 times. It's lower than that right now. So I think a good outcome is that when you sort of at least go back to that level and then you get some earnings growth. And there, I've discussed this with you before, my view is that earnings growth will not be that impacted by demonetization. Seems to be being borne out now in the earnings season. I think you get about, the consensus estimates are close to 15-16%. Yes. Even if you take some downside to that, if you add 5% to that, you have anywhere between 15 to 20, maybe closer to 20. That's what I think.
We are speaking about 35,000 Sensex.
Well, it could happen. Someday it will go to a new high. Someday it has to. Earnings are growing, so
but
hopefully...
But FY17, a realistic number would be?
I personally think about 18-20% return on Sensex, given the fact that the multiples have some catch-up to do and that earnings growth. And also remember, we are getting a very good global environment. There's been a huge depression in overall earnings from commodities, and that will also start to play back, not only in commodity stocks, also in banks, which have suffered a lot of the commodity sort of pull down. So the overall macro environment is pretty supportive, you know.
If it's a Sensex Nifty 18-20% for the past 2 years, mid-caps have outperformed, so perhaps more gains in that space, I do not know. Aditya, what gains will you go with?
I'd probably go with a number of 14-15, in part because I think you've got to be a little watchful about earnings. You know, they've tended to disappoint in the past, and while I know everyone said it's going to be different this time and this is why it's going to be different, I think you just need to be a little cautious there. But what I do believe is that you should, by the end of the year, which is where you're looking for a kind of a return time frame, I think, you know, the pain, the distortion or the disruption that has been done over the last 6 months and will happen with GST, I think the gains of that will start showing through in some form or the other.
So
the willingness of the market to value it up a little bit will be there. But I think you also need to look at it from a money flow perspective. I think it's going to go down very well with the domestic market. With, I think, the offshore market, I think it's going to be a slightly different story, because what has happened is, you know, India has been a big favorite with them for an extended period because of the potential and because of reform. Now all of that has come through, and now people are looking at it as a market rather than something with huge potential.
So you have to outperform.
Effectively, yes. I think so. You know, that's why you've had this pain with some of the money.
Fair point.
So I think that's a
I'm looking for a number, because we have to wind up. Navneet, what might we expect?
If we deliver 13-15% over a three-year period, I think investors would be quite happy looking at where the deposit rates are. Looking at where the deposit rates are and what are the return expectations from the other asset classes. I think investors should be happy with that.
That's the minimum that our experts are putting, a minimum of 13 CAGR over the next 3 years, and 15-18, as Prabhat puts it. So that's the range of expectations. And Sudhir Kapadia saying last year the budget got a AAA, it can't fall below that level in this February 1st event as well. Thank you very much for joining me in the Big Budget Brainstorm.